Cindy Moore, and I'm the owner and designer at Fun Club Designs. Today I'm going to show you how I use an everyday kitchen product to help with my embroidery. Marking embroidery lines on cotton is pretty straightforward and simple, but when you want to get an embroidery line on wool, it can sometimes be more difficult. So today I'm going to focus on how I did the embroidery on this of this lettering on this wall hanging. Press and Seal is a very inexpensive product found in your grocery store. It's in the same aisle as the plastic wrap and the tin foil. It's made by Glad, and it's a see-through plastic product that's somewhat sticky on one side and smooth on the other. So for this project, what I did was tear a little piece away, and you want to take your paper pattern, lay it down, and with the sticky side down, go ahead and press the Press and Seal down onto your pattern. The next thing you want to do is go ahead and mark the embroidery line onto the Press and Seal. But the key here is to use a pin that's the same color of the floss that you're going to be embroidering with. And the reason why is sometimes little remnants of the ink color will come off onto your floss. And if it's the same color, you'll never notice it. But if it's a different color, then your project will be ruined because you won't want to see that wrong color on there. So since we embroidered with red floss here, I'm going to use a red Sharpie pen, but you could also use a ballpoint pen. But you're just going to go along and trace your embroidery line onto the Press and Seal. Like such. Alternatively, sometimes I will use this black ballpoint pen made by Pilot. It's a heat-sensitive pen called a friction pen. And even though this is a black ink, the reason I will use it is even if some of the black ink comes off onto the floss, I can take a blow dryer and just heat it up and it'll disappear. Let's say that we're doing something on black wool. The same process will work with the Press and Seal as long as you use the right color ink pen. This is a white pigment pen, and you can see that it writes very well on the Press and Seal, and you could do any design you wanted and let it dry and then go ahead and finish your stitching. So once you're done tracing your design, let me finish the last lettering. Go ahead and peel up the Press and Seal off of your pattern, and then place it down in the position that you want on your background fabric. And finger press it to your fabric. The beauty of this is if you get it in the wrong spot, you can go ahead and peel it up again and reposition it. It's real friendly that way. So what you have when you're done is your background fabric with your Press and Seal on with the embroidery line clearly marked. At this point, you're ready to embroider. If you typically use a hoop, you can easily hoop your project with the Press and Seal on. And the key here is to go ahead and embroider as you would normally. Make sure that you go through the Press and Seal and the wool both. And in this case, I'm using a stem stitch. One thing about this technique is it works very well if you have a stitch that's pretty tightly stitched, like a stem stitch. You wouldn't want to use it with a looser stitch, such as a running stitch or a lazy daisy, something that will easily pull apart. So, when you have your embroidery finished, what you end up with is basically your embroidered block, and at this point, you just take some scissors and cut away the big pieces of Press and Seal. And then you're left with small little pieces that are right up next to the embroidery. And if you take a close look, you can see how easily this press and seal will just tear away. And I tend to tear kind of to the side rather than straight up. And if there's any like real small little pieces, you can always use tweezers to come in and get that. But you can see how easily that just tears up. So, again, when you're using this technique, use the same color ink as the floss that you're using, and make sure that you're using a stitch that's pretty tightly embroidered so that when you tear the press and seal away, you won't tear your stitches out. Anyway, I hope you give this method a try, and happy stitching!